Hello, my name is Debbie Carney. I am a part-time reference librarian here at Bucks. In this lesson, I will be going over how to use the database ScienceDirect. ScienceDirect is an online database that includes full-text articles and abstracts focused on the sciences. You can access it from the list of online resources at the Bucks Library webpage. If you are on campus, you will not need to log in. But if you are off campus, you will need to use the same username and password that you use to log on to on-campus computers to access the database. We will begin at the Bucks homepage. In the upper right-hand corner of the screen, we will select the link for Library. This brings us to the Bucks Library webpage. We will now go ahead and select the icon for databases. The alphabetical list of online databases appears, and we will scroll down until we see ScienceDirect. This brings us to the ScienceDirect homepage. We will begin by selecting the search link in the upper left-hand corner. We can now go ahead and type our search terms. Our topic will be sport-related concussions, and the next step is to type these search terms in the search box. We will now limit the search by placing a check mark in the box next to the document type article. This will restrict our search to scholarly articles. We can now go ahead and click on the search button. Our search results appear, and we can see that our search yielded 585 articles. When you retrieve a large number of search results, it is a good idea to limit your search. We will begin by limiting our search results by publication year. In ScienceDirect, the tools to limit your search results are on the left-hand side of the screen. If you scroll to the bottom of the page, you will see the tool that allows you to limit your search by year of publication. We will limit our search to those articles published from 2008 to the present. To do this, we will place a check mark in the years we want included. We will now go ahead and select the Limit To button. The revised search results appear, and we can see our search results have been reduced from 585 down to 184. Another way to limit your search results in ScienceDirect is by topic. To view all available topics, we will click on the plus sign next to View More. The number next to the topic indicates the number of articles available on the particular topic. At this point, I am not going to further limit my search results. Let's now turn our attention to looking at the first page of search results. You will notice that there is a green icon next to the first few articles listed. These icons are explained here in the upper left-hand corner. A green box indicates that the article is available in full text, or you will be able to view the entire article. The gray box indicates only an abstract or brief summary of the article is available. Let's go ahead and select an article from our list of results. I am going to go ahead and select the fourth article, Concussion in Athletes. To view the full text of the article, we will click on the PDF button. The PDF of the article appears. Using the icons in the upper left-hand corner, we can print or save the article. To return to the results page, we simply click the close button in the upper right-hand corner. This brings us back to the detailed record for this article. Click on Back to Results to return to the list of results. This concludes the tutorial on ScienceDirect. If you have additional questions, please ask a librarian.